Hello everyone, this is Glenda Winkleman and welcome back to Creative Grandma. Today's episode is for the no border towel with topper. This matches the no border dishcloth, so if you wanted to make a set with the towel and the dishcloth, this is the perfect set. This pattern was a special request from one of my subscribers, so Nancy, this is for you. This is an excellent, easy pattern for beginners. So I hope everyone likes this pattern, and I always list the instructions at the end of the video, and I also include my email address. If you want to email me and get the pattern before you follow along with the video, that is great too. So let's get started, and I'll be right back to tell you what you need. So to start this design, we're going to need 2 full balls of your main color. Now these are 2.8 ounces or 80 grams. So 2 full balls for your main color, and then you don't need this much, but just a little bit of 2 other colors for your accent colors. So with the main color, we're going to go ahead and you're going to chain 44 with your size H8 or 5mm hook. And I'll be right back after I make my chain. So go ahead and get ready. And we'll begin. I have my chain 44 ready. So we're going to begin row 1. So let me zoom up a little bit so you can see my stitches a little better. We're going to start and we're going to skip this first chain. We're going to single crochet into the second chain. So insert your hook into the second chain, yarn over the hook, pull it through your chain, yarn over the hook, pull it through 2 loops on your hook. Now you're going to look for your next chain, which is here. You can see each chain. You're going to work a double crochet into your next chain. Yarn over the hook, insert into that next chain, yarn over the hook, pull it through the chain, yarn over the hook, pull it through 2 loops on your hook, yarn over the hook, pull it through 2 loops on your hook. That is your double crochet. So the pattern we're going to do across is a single crochet in the next chain, insert your hook in the next chain, yarn over the hook, pull it through the chain, yarn over the hook, pull it through 2 loops on your hook. So now the repeat pattern across is you'll work a double crochet in the next chain, a single crochet in the next, a double crochet in the next, a single crochet in the next chain, and when you get to the end of your chain, you will be ending with a single crochet in that ending chain. So I'll show you one more time. You're going to work a double crochet into that next chain, yarn over the hook, insert it in that chain, yarn over the hook, pull it through the chain, yarn over the hook, pull it through 2 loops on the hook, yarn over the hook, pull it through 2 loops. That's your double crochet. Now you're going to work a single crochet in the next chain, insert into the next chain, yarn over the hook, pull it through that chain, yarn over the hook, and pull it through 2 loops on your hook. So go ahead and repeat your double crochet, single crochet across, ending with a single crochet, and I will meet you at the end of row 1. I'm at the end of row 1, and this is what your piece should look like. It's a little long, so it's hard to get it all in the video. You can see your double crochets popping out just a little bit. That's where you get your texture. So, okay, I'm going to zoom back in and we're going to start row two, I'm sorry. So you're going to chain 1, yarn over the hook, and pull it through your loop. You're going to turn your work. And you're going to work a single crochet into this first single crochet. So skip this chain 1 space. And like I said, some new beginners have a lot of trouble because they're thinking this is a stitch. if you work in that stitch, you're going to increase and you're going to throw off your design. So skip your chain one space and come down and look for your first single crochet. Now with this pattern, you're going to always start and end with a single crochet. So if you're not sure where your stitch is, go down and look for the bottom of the stitches. Or turn your work slightly and look for these two loops here, and that might help you. So go ahead and work a single crochet, insert your hook into that first single crochet, yarn over the hook, pull it through the stitch, yarn over the hook, pull it through two loops on the hook. Now you have a double crochet stitch here, so we're going to work a single crochet in the double crochet. So it's the opposite going across of what you did in the previous row. So we're going to single crochet in that next double crochet, insert your hook into that stitch, yarn over the hook, pull it through the stitch, yarn over the hook, pull it through the stitch. So with this pattern, you're going to alternate. You're going to have one row that has one single crochet in the starting, and the next row will have two single crochets. Then the third row will have one single crochet, row four would start with two, and it would always start and end the same. So now we're going to work a double crochet into this next single crochet. And if you're not sure, look, this is a short stitch and you can see how big and long this one is. So you want to double crochet in the single crochet. So yarn over the hook, insert into that single crochet, yarn over the hook, pull it through that stitch, yarn over the hook, pull it through two loops on the hook. Yarn over the hook, pull it through two loops on the hook. Now we're going to work a single crochet into the next double crochet. So insert your hook into that double crochet, yarn over the hook, pull it through the stitch, yarn over the hook, pull it through two loops on the hook. So row two is basically, we're going to do a double crochet in each single crochet and a single crochet in the next double crochet in the next single, single crochet in the next double. You're going to end with a single crochet in this double crochet and a single crochet in the ending single crochet. So go ahead and work your pattern across. You're going to work the double crochet in the single and a single in the double, ending with two single, and I'll meet you at the end of row two. Okay, I'm almost to the end of row two, and this is what your piece should look like. You can see the texture forming. Now, to end row two, we're going to end with two single crochet. I done my last double crochet. The next stitch is a double crochet, so we're going to work a single crochet in that last double crochet. And then we're going to work a single crochet in this last single crochet. So insert your hook under those two loops of that last single crochet, yarn over, pull it through your last single crochet, yarn over through two loops on hook. So if you look at the start of row two, you can see we started with two single crochet and then we ended with two single crochet. So we're going to start row three. So you're going to chain one, you're going to turn your work. In row three, we always start and end with a single crochet. So look for that first single crochet, skip that chain one space, and you can always find your stitches by turning it slightly and looking for those loops. So go ahead and insert your hook in that stitch, work your single crochet. Now you can see the next stitch is a single crochet because it's short. The next one is a double crochet because it's long. Short is single crochet and long. So whatever the stitch is, if this is a single crochet, you're going to double crochet in it. If it's a double crochet, you're going to single crochet. So we're going to double crochet in that next single crochet. We're going to single crochet into this next double crochet. So that forms your pattern across. I'll show you one more time. You're going to double crochet into that next single crochet. And you're going to single crochet into this next double crochet. And you're going to repeat that across. And you will be ending with one single crochet. So go ahead and finish row 3, and I will meet you at the end of row 3. I'm at the end of row 3, and this is what your work should look like. This is the front of your work. This is the back of your work. So now what we're going to do is for row 4, we're going to add our accent colors. So the next 3 rows are just going to be single crochet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fasten off row 3. I'm going to turn my work. I'm going to insert my hook into that first beginning single crochet right underneath those 2 loops there. Then I'm going to grab this piece of yarn that I cut off, and I just pull it behind my work. I'm going to grab my new color. I'm going to leave a little dangly piece. I hold that behind my work. I just pull that new color through with my hook, and I'm going to chain 1. I'm going to insert in that same beginning single crochet, and I work underneath my threads. My hook goes underneath those threads, yarn over, pull it through your stitch, yarn over, pull it through 2 loops on the hook. And what I'm doing is I'm crocheting over my ends, and then you won't see them on the back. They'll be underneath the stitches. So insert your hook into the next stitch. Hold your threads behind your work, yarn over, pull it through the stitch, yarn over, pull it through 2 loops. So now we're making single crochet. Insert into the next stitch, yarn over the hook, pull it through the stitch, yarn over the hook, pull it through 2 loops. Insert into the next stitch, yarn over the hook, pull it through the stitch, yarn over the hook, pull it through 2 loops. And when you went as far as you want to go to weave those ends in, then you just take your scissors and be very careful. I try to hold the thread that I'm working with up, and then I just grab these 2, and then I just snip them off. Just being careful you don't cut into your stitches. So go ahead and work a row of single crochet across your work to the end in whatever accent color you want. And I will meet you at the end of row 4. I'm at the end of row 4. I worked my last single crochet in the last single crochet of row 3. And this is what your piece should look like now. And that's the back of your work. So you can see the front has the texture. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to fasten this off the same way I did the last row. I'm just going to nip that yarn there. I'm going to fasten off. I'm going to turn my work. I'm going to grab my new color, which I chose white. I'm going to pull this color behind my work. I'm going to leave a small piece dangling. And I also put that behind my work. I'm going to insert my hook into this first single crochet, and I'm just going to pull that new color through. You're going to chain 1, and you're going to work a single crochet in that same beginning single crochet. So basically row 5 is the same as row 4. You're going to just work a single crochet into each single crochet across. And I just work my stitches right over my ends, and that helps weave them in the back. So work as many stitches across that you feel is good for your ends to be weaved in. Snip off those ends and continue working single crochet in each stitch across to the end. And I will meet you at the end of row 5. I'm at the end of row 5, and this is what your piece should look like. You can see that you have your main color. You did your first accent color, your second. Now, row 6 will be coming back to our first accent color and repeating with just a row of single crochet. So again, I'm just going to fasten off my work same as before. I'm going to turn my work. I'm going to insert my hook into that first single crochet. I bring my yarn up, my new color. I leave a small piece. It's hard to videotape that. Small piece hanging. I just put that to the back of my work along with the other piece. I pull that new color through. You're going to chain one and you're going to work a single crochet into that very first single crochet of the row. And again, you're going to work your stitches right over your two ends here on the back of your work, and that weaves them in, so when you're finished with your piece, none of that terrible weaving in ends. So go ahead and work your single crochet across your row, working over your stitches, trim them when you feel that they're weaved in enough. Single crochet in each stitch across, and I will meet you at the end of row 6. I'm at the end of row 6, and this is what your piece should look like. You can see you're textured with your main color here, and then your single crochet accent rows are flatter. So now what we're going to do is we're going to fasten off our accent color, and we're going to join our main color, and we're going to pick up our single crochet double crochet pattern. So turn your work. You're going to pull your main color back through that first single crochet. You're going to chain one, and you're going to single crochet in that first beginning single crochet. So now we're going to start our repeat pattern across. You're going to do a double crochet into the next single crochet. You're going to work a single crochet into the next single crochet. Oops. A double crochet into the next stitch. A single crochet into the next. And you're going to repeat that across. You're going to work a double crochet in the next stitch, a single crochet in the next stitch, a double crochet in the next stitch, a single crochet in the next stitch, and you will end with one single crochet in this last single crochet. So go ahead and work across row 7, and I'll meet you at the end of row 7. I'm at the end of row 7. And you can see how our textured pattern is starting above our single crochet accent rows. So now for the remainder of the tau portion for rows 8 through 43, you're going to repeat rows 2 and 3 of the pattern that we did previously. And you're going to repeat rows 2 and 3 for a total of 18 times until you have a total of 43 rows. So you're going to just chain one and turn your work, and then you're going to begin row 2 and then work row 3 for a total of 18 times until you get and complete row 43. Now, if you did not get a copy of the instructions, they are at the end of this video, and my email address is also in this video. If you prefer that I just email you a copy so you can print it out and follow along, or you can just click back on the video and watch how I did rows 2 and 3 over again to help you finish to row 43, and I'll meet you at the end of row 43. I'm at the end of row 43, and this is what your towel should look like. You can see a little bit of the textured design in your towel. So now what we're going to do is we're going to start the top of the towel topper, but we're going to decrease our stitches pretty rapidly. We're going to go from 43 stitches down to 9 stitches in the next few rows. So what we're going to do now is we're going to start our first row of decreases. So let me zoom up if you've never decreased before. Okay, we're going to chain one and we're going to turn our work. Now this is row 44 and we're going to single crochet two together 21 times across with a single crochet in the last single crochet. So to do a decrease and to do a single crochet two together, we already chained our one, so you're going to skip this chain one space here. You're going to insert your hook into the next stitch, into that first beginning stitch. You're going to pull your yarn over the hook and pull it through that stitch. You're going to insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over the hook, pull it through the stitch. Now you're going to put your yarn over the hook and pull it through all three loops. You just decreased one single crochet. So there, you took those two single stitches there and made them into one single crochet. So we're going to go ahead and do that across to the last single crochet. I'll show you a couple more times. Insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over the hook, pull it through the stitch. Insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over the hook, pull it through the stitch. Three loops on hook, yarn over, pull it through all three loops on the hook. You just decreased one more single crochet. And we're going to do that all the way across. So insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull it through the stitch. Insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull it through the stitch. Three loops on hook, yarn over, pull through all three loops on hook. I'll show you one more time. Insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull it through. Insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull it through. Three loops on hook. Yarn over, pull through all three loops on the hook. And you'll see how it's starting to pull together. And we do want that to do that because you're trying to decrease all these stitches to get to your topper. So go ahead and work that across, and you will be working one single crochet in the last stitch across, and I'll meet you at the end of row 44. I'm at the end of row 44, and if you see my sample that I'm working on, you can see how it's starting to puff out and gather. That's exactly what you want. That's what we're trying to do. So now to do row 45, let me zoom back in here. For row 45, we're going to decrease 11 times across. So we're going to chain one, and then you're going to turn your work. You're going to skip this chain one space here. And get that. So this is your chain one, skip that. Insert your hook into that first single crochet of the row. yarn over, pull it through the stitch. Insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull it through the stitch. Three loops on hook, yarn over, pull it through all three loops. That was your first decrease. And we're going to repeat that 10 more times across. I'll show you one more time. You're going to insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull it through the stitch. Insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull it through the stitch. Three loops on hook, yarn over, pull it through all three loops on hook. Insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull it through the stitch. You have two loops on the hook. Insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull it through the stitch. You have three loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull it through all three loops. So go ahead and continue that across, and I'll meet you at the end of row 45. I'm at the end of row 45, and you should have a total of 11 stitches across the top from end to end. There should be 11 single crochet. We're trying to get down to 9. So what we're going to do in the next row is we're going to do one decrease in the beginning and one decrease at the end of the row. So we're going to start row 46. So you're going to chain one, you're going to turn your work. You're going to single crochet. First, make sure you skip that chain one space that you made, and you're going to single crochet into that first single crochet. You're going to single crochet two together, which is a one decrease. Insert your hook into that next stitch, yarn over, pull it through the stitch. Two loops on your hook. Insert your hook into that next stitch, yarn over, pull it through the stitch. Three loops on hook. Yarn over, pull it through all three loops on your hook. Now you're going to work one single crochet into each of the next 5 single crochet stitches. So there's 1, 2, 3, it tends to want to curl down, 4, and 5. Now we're going to decrease one single crochet. So we're going to single crochet two together. So insert your hook in that next stitch, yarn over, pull it through the stitch. Two loops on hook. Insert your hook into that next stitch, yarn over, pull it through the stitch. Three loops on hook, yarn over, pull through all three loops on hook. Now you're going to single crochet into this last single crochet here. And now you should have a total of 9 single crochet. So this will slant and move over, but you'll see it's very, let me zoom out a little. You can see how puffy it is. That's how we want it because we're gathering it together. So now what we're going to do is for row 47, we're going to start our single crochet, double crochet pattern again. So for that, for row 47, we're going to chain one. Whoops, let me zoom in. Whoops. I chained one. Now we're going to turn our work. You're going to skip this chain one space here, and you're going to work a single crochet in that first single crochet. So single crochet in the first single crochet, you're going to double crochet into the next single crochet. You're going to single crochet into the next single crochet. You're going to double crochet into the next stitch. You're going to single crochet into the next. Double crochet into the next stitch. Single crochet into the next. Let me count my stitches. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have 2 stitches to go. So you're going to double crochet into this next stitch. And then you're going to end with a single crochet into the ending single crochet. And make sure you do not go in these sides of your towel. That's where it's pulling over. So make sure you see where your top stitches are. This is the last single crochet, so we're going to single crochet in that stitch. So you should still have 9 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So now we're going to begin row 48. Now rows 47 and 48 will be your repeat rows to make your strap. So for row 48, we're just going to continue the pattern. We're going to chain 1. We're going to turn our work. You're going to skip this chain 1 space, and you always start and end with a single crochet. So single crochet in that beginning single crochet. Your next stitch is a double crochet. You can tell by how long it is. So if it's a double crochet, you're going to single crochet into it. So single crochet in that next double crochet. The next stitch is a single crochet, so you're going to work a double crochet into that stitch. You're going to single crochet in this next double crochet. You're going to double crochet into the next single crochet. You're going to single crochet into this next double crochet. You're going to double crochet into this next single crochet. You're going to single crochet into this next double crochet. And then you will end with a single crochet in the ending single crochet. So now you're going to work rows 49 through 68, and you're only going to work across these 9 stitches here to form your strap. So go ahead and work rows 49 through 68. And you're going to repeat rows 47 and 48 10 times. So when you're at the end of row 68, we'll meet up and I'll show you how to finish off your strap with your buttonhole and finish our towel topper. See you then. I'm at the end of row 68 here of our handle, but I just wanted to show you what your piece should look like at this point. You can see that you have your kitchen towel. It's gathered at the top, and you made your handle. So what we're going to do is the last 3 rows, which forms the buttonhole. So we're going to take our work. Let me zoom in here so you can see better. So for row 69, we're going to chain one. You're going to turn your work. You're going to single crochet in this first single crochet. You're going to double crochet into the next stitch. You're going to single crochet into the next stitch. You're going to chain three, one, two, and three. You're going to skip the next three chain, and then you're going to work a single crochet in that next stitch. A double crochet into the next stitch. And a single crochet into that last single crochet. And that forms your buttonhole. So now we're going to start row 70. We're going to chain one. We're going to turn our work. We're going to single crochet into this first single crochet. We're going to single crochet into the next stitch. We're going to double crochet into the next stitch. And then for your chain three space, we're going to work a single crochet in the chain three space. We're going to work a double crochet into the chain three space. And a single crochet all in that same chain three space. And then we're going to work a double crochet into the next stitch. And we're going to end our row with a single crochet in each of the last two stitches. So there you can see your buttonhole. So now for the final row, we're going to chain one. We're going to turn our work. You're going to single crochet in the beginning single crochet. You're going to double crochet into the next stitch. Single crochet into the next. So you're just going to repeat that across. You're going to work a double crochet into the next stitch. A single crochet into the next. I might as well just go ahead and work across and finish the row. A double crochet into the next stitch. A single crochet into the next stitch. Double crochet into the next. And you're going to end with a single crochet in that ending single crochet. Now, when you do fasten off your final row, make sure you leave a little bit of a length so you can get it weaved in the back. If you cut it too short, it's harder to weave. So I just fasten off. So here is, let me zoom out a little. Whoops. So here is our finished piece. This is the right side. If you left your little starter from your chain, it should be on the right or the left side. So this is the right side of your piece. So what you're going to do now is you're just going to, with the right side of your towel facing, you're just going to fold this down. You'll weave in your ends. Fold this down so it lines up. So just go ahead and fold it down so it lines up with the top of your towel. Kind of see where your button goes. There's my buttonhole. So I'm going to take my button and I'm just going to, my hand's in the way. I'm just going to place that button underneath there. Okay, line it up. And then I'm going to sew that in place. So after I sew that in place, I'll go ahead and do that and I'll be right back. I sewed my button on. I weaved in all my ends. It's kind of hard to get the whole thing into the shot. So now you have the right side of the kitchen towel facing. It's gathered. You just bring the top down, line it up with your button. And there you have it. I hope you enjoyed this episode of the cotton kitchen towel with topper. And please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.